The Beaverton edition of 10 Tiny Dances is a little bit different because it's 5 stages outside. Audience moves between the 5 stages to see all 10 dances, where traditionally 10 Tiny Dances was done with 1 stage in a restaurant or a bar. All 10 artists worked on the same stage. So this gives us a different experience, kind of exciting for the artists to work a little bit more site specific, and they're dealing with the space and the site as well as the audience changing. Very positive. I think people are delighted by the full palette of dances they get to see in 10 Tiny Dances. Each one's different. They've seemed to enjoy the work we're doing at this site. 10 Tiny Dances traditionally has not involved particularly traditional ethnic forms, and that's a big focus of Beaverton. We're trying to reflect the racial and ethnic diversity here in Beaverton, and that's been exciting to represent artists of different cultures. I think it already is, and I'm happy that it is. It's lovely support here and a lovely audience. We have a great time.
There must be something at a kilter. I think 'twixt the Negroes of the South and the women of the North, all talking about rights, the white men will be in a fix pretty soon. But what's all this here talk about? That man over there says that women need to be helped into carriages, lifted over ditches, and given the best place everywhere. But nobody ever helped me into carriages or over mud puddles. Or gave me any best place. And ain't I a woman? Look at me. Look at my arm. I have plowed and planted and gathered into barns. And no man can head me. And ain't I a woman? I could work as much and eat as much. I said I could work as much. When I could get it, and bear the lash as well. And ain't I a woman? I have bore 13 children. Which all I have seen sold off into slavery. And when I cried out with my mother's grief, none but Jesus heard me. And ain't I a woman? And then they talk about this thing all in the head. What's this they call it? Intellect. Intellect.
Intellect.
Intellect. That's it, honey.
That's it.
Intellect. What's that got to do with women's rights or Negroes' rights? If my cup won't hold but a pint and yours pour, wouldn't you be mean not to let me have my little half measure full? And that little man in black there, he says that women can't have as much rights as men because Christ wasn't a woman. But where did your Christ come from? Did your Christ come from? From God and a woman. Men had nothing to do with it. Now, if the first woman God ever made was strong enough to turn the world upside down all alone, then these women ought to be able to turn it back. And now they's asking to do so, the men better let them. Obliged to you for hearing me.